determine for themselves what portions of the Bible apply to them, and rejected anything God said that they did not like. Are we like that, you know? If it's a part of the Bible that we like, we want to take it and hit people over the head with it. If it's something we don't want to do, we try to ignore it, don't we? Now here's what they were. They were just like vipers. Small, slithery, deadly desert snake. But lying still, they looked harmless. But pick one up, and you will die. That's what the Pharisees and the Sadducees were. Small men who proclaimed themselves to be big. We got too many folk who think they're big and ain't about nothing. Am I right about that? You think you are that and a bag of chips, but let me tell you something. God made a way for you. You ought to say thank you. You ought to be willing to praise his name. You ought to be real. And thank the Lord for what he brought you from. Hallelujah. They're big, baby-faced assassin. You know what an assassin is? An assassin is somebody who will kill you. Now, you don't have to be an assassin with a gun. You can be an assassin with your mouth. Who look harmless on the outside, or plotting their sinister deed on the inside. We got a lot of folk like that. They'll smile in the face and stab you in the back. Am I right about that? We got some slithery folk who walk contradicted their talk. Am I right about that? They got a good talk, but they don't have a good walk. Men of death who proclaim themselves to be sources of life. John questioned their character and criticized their hypocrisy and warned them to flee God's wrath. John hit the bull's eye with pinpoint accuracy. True repentance, the kind that John demanded of these people, had nothing to do with what they said or how they felt. Yes. Am I right about that? Yes. But one thing about John knew his place. He understood his role. There aren't many people these days who are content with being number two. Vice president, desire one day to be president. But John was a humble man. He possessed the perfect blend of humility mixed with intensity. He was the humble child to taste the grace. Am I right about that? One of our problems today in the world is that humility has been thrown out the window. Everyone thinks that they are better than what they really are. Thank God for where he brought you from. Am I right about that? God is good. I said God is good. I said God is good. Every now and then. It's all right to clap your hands. Christmas season, John laid the foundation. Those of you in this church today, even when you're dead and gone, if you live right and be real, you'll lay the foundation for somebody else. Many of you in this church today because your parents and your grandparents, your aunt and your uncle, laid the groundwork for you. Amen? That's why you can appreciate the church. That's why you can shed some tears sometimes. Because you see your forefathers do it. That's why you can work in the church. That's why you can sing songs of praise. That's why you can clap your hands. Celebrate Christmas during this Christmas break. So I had to get your credit card filled. But you got to get some spiritual food from God. Amen. God will. I said, God will.